a brand new day.
This morning
I'm stepping, yeah, stepping on my way.
Good morning,
you give me strength,
yeah,
you give me just what I need. And I can feel the hope that's rising up in me.
Good morning,
yeah, yeah.
Good morning, Grizzlies. I'm Riley Sargent.
And I'm Lauren Moss, bringing your GNews broadcast for Friday, September 23rd.
Just a reminder, voting for homecoming court will take place today due to recent weather conditions. Attention juniors and seniors. Roe Capital National Social Studies Honor Society recognizes students for their achievements in history and government classes.
Dues will be a one-time fee of $10. Membership in Roe Capital may be listed on college applications and resumes as a national honor. Interested juniors and seniors should pick up an application for Ms. Prince in C-113 before or after school. All applications are due by Thursday, October 6th at 3:30 p.m. Hey Grizzlies, do you wish it was still summer? Why not relive those great memories in a yearbook? If you have a summer photo you would like us to consider using, please tag us on Instagram at @GFHS_media or email us at gnewscrew@gmail.com. Also, don't forget if you pre-order your copy of the paw print before September 30th, you can save $10 and get free icons. Visit www.justinsyearbooks.com. The Grassfield Volleyball Program will host the annual Grizzly Pink Owl on Thursday, October 20th, starting at 5 p.m. Pack the place in pink and order your very own Grizzly Pink Out shirt. Please see Ms. Smith in room C-105 for an order form or questions. That due to weather, the Pink Out t-shirt deadline is extended to Monday the 26th.
Grizzly Gamers First Club meeting is scheduled for Thursday, September 29th in room D-119 after school. The meeting will run until about 4:25 and the activity bus will be available for students needing transportation home. If you have any questions, you can ask Ms. Foster or Mr. Gable for information.
If you want to make a difference in your community through volunteering and community service, then the Key Club is the club for you. We will be holding a Key Club interest meeting on Wednesday, September 28th at 8:15 in the auditorium. Please come out and see what we are all about. There will be a Technology Student Association meeting in room 213 on Tuesday, September 27th to organize and nominate officers for the year. We will meet from 3:45 to 4:20 p.m. Activity bus passes will be available for those who need them. All students are welcome. Any girls interested in trying out for the girls' basketball team, please see Coach Jameson in room A115 for conditioning information.
What's your story? That's the question being asked in this year's PTSA Reflections Contest. The deadline to enter is October 21st. See Mrs. Fitzgerald with any questions. The next World Language Club meeting is Tuesday, September 27th after school in the Forum. We will be getting started on our homecoming float. Don't forget to submit your ideas to our Google form by September 23rd. See a sponsor for more information. Auditions for the first play of the year, The Crucible, will be held on Monday, October 3rd after school. Please sign up for an audition time and pick up a monologue to memorize for your audition outside of room 501, the drama room. If you have any questions, please see Ms. Agadello. Stay tuned after the pledge for our Friday sports wrap. Now please pause for a moment of silence.
Please stand for the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Hey Grizzlies, and welcome to our Friday Sports Wrap. I'm Lauren Moss.
Our JV field hockey team defeated Kingsport last Wednesday 6-0. The varsity field hockey team also defeated Kingsport 8-0 at home.
Mackenzie Tomes scored a total of 4 goals, helping the defeat of the Bulldogs. Tomes scored 3 goals in the first 2 minutes of the second half.
Our golf team defeated Oscar Smith 352-369, and Josh Africa carded 2 over 74 to earn medalist honor.
Boys and girls volleyball compete on Tuesdays and Thursdays. Take a look at their progress.
Last Thursday, the boys and girls volleyball teams competed against Kings Fork. The girls won in 3 sets. Erica Anderson contributed with 9 aces, Taylor Dedewick had 9 kills, and Courtney Gorham had 7 aces. The boys also defeated the Bulldogs 3-0. Jason Bird had 7 aces. Tyler Liebig and Billy McConnell both contributed with 4 aces. The boys traveled to the Endless Summer Tournament at the Virginia Beach Convention Center this past weekend. After placing 2nd in their net pool play, the boys advanced to the semifinals against Cox High School. The team won 2 sets against Cox and moved on to play Cosby High School. In the championship match, the Grizzlies ended up winning 3 sets against the Titans and receiving first place overall. Josh Berman was voted onto the all-tournament team as well. On Tuesday night, the boys' volleyball team took on Lakeland and won 3-1. Todd and Tyler Liebig combined for 15 aces, and Josh Berman had 8 kills. This is Haley Steinling reporting for Genius Sports.
The JV football team defeated Hickory 14-0 Thursday. James Kontowski completed both Grizzly touchdowns. Varsity football faced off against rival Hickory. Let's see how they did.
Last Friday, the Grassville varsity football team took on Hickory at home. Grizzlies came off to an early lead with a touchdown by TJ Scott right before the Hawks kicker, Tommy Martin, kicked a 33-yard field goal. Going into halftime, Grizzlies held a lead of 7-3. Austin Woods ran for a 26-yard catch from Justice Bigby in the third quarter. In the fourth quarter, Woods caught a 15-yard pass from Bigby, putting the Grizzlies up 21-7. To top off the game, Teron Oliver scored with a 1-yard plunge. Mark Rittenhauer capitalized on each touchdown, leaving the Grizzlies undefeated with a 28-3 win against the Hickory Hawks. For GNews Sports, this is Angel Bell with photographer Ryan Lesh.
Many upsets occurred on Friday, but with the Grizzlies' strong performance against Hickory, the team earned a spot with only 5 other undefeated teams. Lansdowne, Salem, Cox, Grassfield, and Atlantic Shores remain unbeaten. Good luck, boys, as you take on the Braves at Indian River. Thanks for tuning in to GNews Sports. Have a great weekend.